Have we forgotten the love Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam had for this ummah? Have we forgotten the love Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam had for you and I? Have we forgotten the worry and concern Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam had for this ummah, had for you and I? Have we forgotten the favors and blessings we were showered with because of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Have we forgotten the wounds that were inflicted on the person of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of this ummah, because of you and I? Have we forgotten the blood that came out of the blessed body of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of this ummah? Have we forgotten the tears that rolled down Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam's eyes and the tears he sallallahu alaihi wasallam shed because of this ummah? Today we have forgotten the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today we neglect the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today we have no value for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have no value for his sunnah. My brothers, today we neglect the rights of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I ask you, did Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever forget you once? Did he sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever neglect this ummah? Did he sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever neglect the rights of this ummah? My brothers, today we neglect Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and we do not fulfill the rights of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No once did he sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever forget this ummah. No once did he sallallahu alaihi wasallam neglect the rights of this ummah. My brothers, you spend the night with your families, you spend the night with your wife and children. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to spend the night worrying and crying about you. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in sajda, tears are flowing from his eyes. He's in prostration, tears are rolling down his cheeks. My brothers, and he stays in this position all night. There is only one verse of the Quran flowing from the blessed lips of Rasulullah. He is praying, O Allah, in tu'adhibhum fa innahum ibaduk wa in taghfir lahum fa innaka antal azizul hakim. O Allah, if you punish my ummah, O Allah, they are your servants. O Allah, they are your slaves. Wa in taghfir lahum. O Allah, if you forgive my ummah and you can so easily forgive them, O Allah, you are the Ghafoor, you are the Rahim, you are the Arhamur Rahimeen, you are the most merciful and most kind. O Allah, if you forgive them, you are the Almighty, you are the All Wise. Another occasion, and yet again, you are the concern of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are on the priority list of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Such was the love Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam had for you, that yet again Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in prostration. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is in sajda. He is bowing down in front of the Lord of the heavens and the earth. Tears are flowing from his eyes again, and this time Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he does not raise his head from sajda till the Almighty Allah pities Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he says to Muhammad, O Muhammad, lan ukhziyaka fi ummatik. O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I will never disgrace you with regards to your ummah. I will make you happy with regards to your ummah. My brothers, yet again, this time Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going for Hajj. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is the Hajjatul Wida, it is the farewell pilgrimage, and yet again you are on the concern list of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is thinking of you. It is the eve of Arafah. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam has his hand raised. He is looking towards the heaven and he is praying, O Allah, I beg you, forgive the ummah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O Allah, forgive all the sins of the ummah Muhammad Rasulullah salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi. The prayer answered, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will forgive all the sins of your ummah except for the huquq al-ibad, except for the rights of man. Such was the love Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam had for you, O Muslims, that Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not satisfied. Yet again he raises his hand, O Allah, I beg you, forgive the rights of the people, forgive the huquq al-ibad. O Allah, if you wish to forgive the huquq al-ibad, you can do so. You are the Arhamur Rahimeen, you are the most merciful, you are the most kind. O Allah, forgive the oppressor and forgive the oppressed one by giving him Jannah, by giving him Jannat al-Firdaus. My brothers, comes Battle of Badr, and yet again you are on the concern list of Rasulullah. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not forget you for one second. Such is the state of the ummah, my brothers, that the ummah, that they are only 313. A mere 313. They are barefooted, they have no shoes to wear, they are hungry, they are thirsty, they are tired, they have never fought before. The Muslims have never fought before this. My brothers, they have no weapons. Some are carrying broken sticks, some are carrying a broken space. And today, the Muslims are going to fight the superpower of the time. The odds are that the Muslims will be defeated today. The odds are the Muslims will be wiped from the face of the earth. The odds are today, nobody will say Allah. Nobody will say Allah. The Muslims will melt in front of the kuffar like snow melts on a hot day. These are the odds, my brothers. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has only one worry. It has only one concern. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tears are flowing from his blessed eyes. And he's saying to Allah, oh Allah, what is going to become of my ummah today? Oh Allah, what is going to become of my ummah today? Oh Allah, Allahumma innahum ufatun fahmilhum. Allahumma innahum uratun faqsuhum. Allahumma innahum jiyaun fashbi'um. Oh Allah, my ummah have come barefooted. They have nothing to mount on. Oh Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, they came walking. Oh Allah, mount them. Oh Allah, my ummah are naked. Their clothes are torn. Oh Allah, clothe them. Allahumma innahum jiyaun. Oh Allah, they are hungry. Oh Allah, they haven't eaten anything. Oh Allah, give them something to eat. Allahumma inni unshiduka ahadak wa wadak. Allahumma in tuhlak hazi al-isaba la tubad. Oh Allah, I beg you, if this small group of Muslims is destroyed today, oh Allah, you will never be worshipped on the face of the earth. He keeps on praying. He prays so much that his hands are raised towards the heavens and tears are flowing from his eyes. He keeps on praying so much that his cloak falls off. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on seeing this pitiful condition of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, comes and clings onto Rasulullah. He puts the shawl back on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I beg you, this is enough. You have cried enough to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have cried enough. Allah will accept your prayer. Allah will honor your prayer. My brothers, when did Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ever forget you? That today you have forgotten Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even when Allah honored our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah called him to the heavens. He called him to the heavens. He honored him. And Allah conversed with Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu wa sallam alayhi. Yet again, you were on the priority list of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has only one concern. He is saying to Allah, oh Allah, you've honored Muhammad by calling him to the heavens. What are you going to give to his ummah? Oh Allah, what about your ummah? And it is there the gift of salah is received for the ummah. My brothers, when did Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forget us? That today we are neglecting the rights of Rasulullah. What were we? What was our status in history? We were nothing. We were zilch. My brothers, we were not even worthy of mention. We were in the depths of darkness. We were in the depths of kufr. We were in the depths of ignorance. Our forefathers were idol worshippers. Our forefathers would worship the stars. Our forefathers would worship the moon. They would worship trees. They would worship stones. My brothers, they would kill on petty arguments. Bloodshed would be spilt over petty arguments. My brothers, they would bury their own daughters alive. They would bury their own flesh and blood alive. They would break relations over petty arguments. Every sin that you can think of was rife in our society. Adultery was rife amongst them. Gambling was rife amongst them. Every sin that you can think of was rife amongst them. The Almighty Allah showed mercy on our forefathers, showed mercy on us, who was tabakum, and Allah the Almighty Himself chose us to become the Ummah Muhammad Rasulullah, wa sammakum al-Muslimin, and Allah honored us by calling us Muslims. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us such a status that the Quran praises us, and the Quran will keep on praising us till the day of judgment. Open the book of Allah and you will see the Quran is saying to you, O Ummati Muhammad, you do not recognize your status. The Quran is saying, Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas, ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhawna 'anil munkar wa tu'minuna billah. O Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are the best people ever raised from mankind. The Quran is saying this to you, and we do not value this. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of this prophet, because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, showered us with such blessings that the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never showered an ummah before this in this manner.